Once again we will start our class of commerce. So in the earlier class I explained you about industry. We have discussed little bit about commerce also, but I have explained you very detailedly about industry, what is mean by industry, what is the process which is taken at industry, which process is called industrial process, and how many types of industries are there according to the classification. We have discussed these all things in our earlier video or in the earlier class also. So industry is nothing but it is the place where we are going to use all the resources which are involved in converting a product into finished product is called as industry. So a raw material is converted into finished good is called as industry. So industries are of different kinds, like we have extractive industry, we have genetic industry, we have constructive industry, we have manufacturing industry, we have service industry also. Normally the industry has been classified in 5 categories only, but some people still they classify manufacturing industry subdivision: assembling, analyzing, analytical, processing. So that 4 extra type of classification is not required for us, because that is a part what we have discussed in our theoretical part when I was discussing you about manufacturing industry: processing, analyzing, analytical and synthetic industry. They are the subdivision of manufacturing industry. So you need not to worry about that 4 subdivision. So if you remember 5 types of industries: extractive, genetic, constructive, manufacturing, service. So what type of work or what type of products they produce and how they are being processed there, we have studied in our earlier class. So now we are going to see the another part, that is called as commerce. Business is divided into 2. One is industry, another one is a commerce. So what is commerce? Now we are going to discuss. Girls, let me tell you first, commerce means it is a foundation step for your whole life. Everywhere, wherever you go, wherever you wherever you deal in your regular life, concept of commerce will come there. Today, if you go to a sea place, there the water is available to you without the help of your efforts or without paying any type of price for that. But that same water, if it is being coming in your house in the form of a tap, then we need to pay the bill for that. So that is nothing but we are using the services of commerce. Suppose you are writing with a pen. At least once, if you think how the pen is coming in your hand and how you are using the utility of that pen in your life, how it is giving the utility to you, for what reason you have purchased that, and how it is satisfying your want, if you think once, you will understand commerce. Commerce means it's nothing but it includes all those types of resources which are involved in free and uninterrupted flow of goods from the place of production to the place of consumption. We will doorsteps of your house, how you are using that without breaking or without interrupting, if you put one question, you will get the answer of commerce. So goods are produced somewhere else at some time in some other place. You don't know who is the producer. You don't know how the goods are reaching you. You don't know in what way the goods are coming. You don't know what is the utility of that goods. You don't know what is the price which has been paid by the producer to produce those goods. But you are paying some reasonable price to use that good for your satisfaction. Once if you put the question yourself, then you will get the answer, that is commerce. So what is commerce? Commerce means nothing but it includes all those activities which are related to transfer of the goods from the place of production to the ultimate consumer. Production nundi, where the goods are produced, akkada nundi consumer chain varaku, whatever the modes or whatever the difficulties or whatever the process which are taking place from the movement of the goods from the hands of producer to the hands of consumer, it includes the concept of commerce. So commerce is nothing but it helps you how to understand the business. So you know the business definition. Business means it is the process of being busy. The person who is busy in his work, we will call him as a businessman. Always a person who is busy in his work cannot be called as a businessman, because sometimes he will be doing economical activity, sometimes he will be doing non-economical activity. But the person who is engaged in economical activity, either he must be engaged in industry or commerce. If he is engaged in industry, we can get a conclusion that he is producing the goods. What type of goods he is producing? Some good is producing. But if you produce the goods and the goods are kept with himself, then what is the use of that good? Whatever the money you invested, whatever the efforts you put, whatever the act you performed in producing the good, that should give you the result, that should fetch you some money, that should give some income to you in return. Suppose now, today, you are studying intermediate. You are studying the intermediate with one object, with one aim, that whatever the group you select, like LBC, BIPC, MBC, CEC, HEC, whatever is that, your ultimate aim will be depends upon your selection of group. Suppose if you are selecting MEC or CEC, you are studying commerce. What is the benefit you are going to get in your whole life from this subject? You will understand what is industry. You will understand what is commerce. You will understand different ways of business institutions like sole proprietor, partnership, joint Hindu family, cooperative society, will go for joint stock company, will go for banking, will go for insurance, will go for transportation, will go for public utilities, different types of businesses, how they will form, how they will do business, how they will earn income, like that. And again, you will learn how to maintain the accounts of these all organizations, what is the purpose of doing accounting of these organizations, how to understand other related things, how to keep the records, like you will get a knowledge perfectly in that. Depending upon that, you will fix your aim in the life. Yes, after inter, I should go to BCom. After BCom, I should go either for CA or for MCom, or I should go for public services. Depends. In that place, when you fill the application form along with one language, you will have one option which you have studied in your academics, commerce, economics, CA, physics, political science, or mathematics like that. It will help you there to show your knowledge. Then, like you will become a perfect or you will get a thorough knowledge, because once you understand the concept correlated with one to another, like that you will develop in that subject. And this is the subject where if you read, it will not give you any result. You should understand that subject. Suppose now if you are feeling hungry and if you want to eat one apple, if you are feeling hungry and if you want to eat one apple, you will go directly to the fruit shop or fruit seller and you will ask him, what is the price of this apple? He will tell one apple 30 rupees or 40 rupees. Can you imagine why he is telling one apple 30 rupees? You will get a doubt. The apple is not produced by that person, that apple grows on the tree. But why he is fixing the 30 rupees for that apple? He is not the producer of, you will get the doubt. He is the producer. But apples will be grown in those places where the apple plantation things are available and the environment is suitable. Now, in India, we may have more apples growing place is Kashmir. It is very famous. And we cannot go from Hyderabad to Kashmir to buy a single apple. How the apples are grown? Who is growing the apples there? What is the process they are undertaking? How the apples are being shifting or being transported from Kashmir to Hyderabad? And who is buying in Hyderabad? And how he is giving to the retail sellers? That is the small people who are buying in the small quantity and selling ultimate to the consumers. And lastly, that person is going to fix the price to your company. So, what is commerce of? You will understand. Apple, it is growing Kashmir. From Kashmir, it is coming to Hyderabad and it is satisfying your desire of eating the apple. So, whatever the process or whatever the things which are facilitating in moving, producing the goods, and moving those goods from the producer point to the consumer point is only called as commerce. So, our commerce includes all those items. That means, what is the commodity you need? Who is the producer? At what price that commodity should be sold? How that commodity is going to give you the satisfaction? All the things which are involved in movement of goods from the producer point to the consumer point will be treated as a commerce. So our commerce means now it includes all those activities which are related to transfer of goods from the place of production to the place of consumer or ultimate consumer. We are going to call it as a commerce. So it includes transportation, it includes warehousing, it includes banking. Like this, what are the different things which are involved in getting the things produced and moving those goods to the ultimate consumer? We will call them as commerce. So, this is one definition I gave you related for commerce, which is very important for our 2 marks. You are supposed to write in your notebook. And if you are feeling this is still more simplified definition. It is the sum total of all those activities which are useful in the uninterrupted and free flow of goods from the place of producer to the place of consumer. It is the sum total of all the activities which are useful in free and uninterrupted process of goods from the producer point to the consumer point is called as commerce. your exam, it is going to come definitely for 2 marks. So I am writing here 2 marks. Now what is the importance of commerce? How we can understand or how we can explain what is mean by commerce? We are telling here it is the free movement of goods from the producer point to consumer point. How and when, why we are going to discuss on how the commerce is going to help the society. First one, importance, bridges the gap between the producer and consumer. Commerce is only one. We are going to discuss with the importance of commerce. That is, we are going to explain how the commerce will help in our regular life. It bridges the gap, or it is going to fulfill the gap which is existing between the producer and consumer. Example, we take again apple. Apple is produced somewhere in the Kashmir, but we are consuming it in Hyderabad. The producer doesn't know who is going to consume that apple. The consumer doesn't know who is producing that apple. How it is coming from Kashmir to Hyderabad? And the producer doesn't know where this apple which he has produced, where it will go, how it will go. Till the consumption pattern is over, what is going to do with that, he doesn't know. So what is the gap or what is the time slag between the production and the consumption will be filled by the commerce. That means the goods produced at one particular place will be consumed by a consumer at another place. That gap between the production and consumption is fulfilled by the commerce. Second one, it ensures the smooth distribution of goods and services. That means, suppose you can see, when the goods are produced, it should reach to the customer in a required time at a required place. Whatever the commodity or whatever the goods which you have produced, without creating any type of disturbances in distribution, making a rise for artificial demand and supply will create the problems. That means any type of problems which are being coming in the free flow of goods and services will disturb both, that is for the producer as well as for the consumer. Consumer will not get a commodity, right commodity at a right place, at a right person and at a right price. He will suffer till that commodity is being coming in his hand for consumption. Producer will get a problem of blocking up of his capital, because once he has kept some money for the production of some commodity, we will call that as an investment. If he sells that commodity, when you produce some goods, that information should pass on to the customer in a required manner, in a proper way, about the commodity name, usage, features, benefits and other things. Then the consumer will buy those goods according to the requirement. If you don't inform, if the information is not passed or the message is not sent, if the consumer doesn't come to know what is the commodities which are floating in the market, then your commodity will not be sold in the market. It will not be purchased by any consumer. Then your investment, whatever you have put in the production of that good, will be substandard. That means not be used by any use for you. The investment what you have kept or whatever you put in the production of that goods will of no use, because you are not getting any return. So what is the second importance of your commerce? It ensures the smooth distribution of goods and services. What are the hurdles? What are the difficulties? What are the disturbances which will come in the movement of goods and services will be overcome by commerce. That means, suppose now we are facing the COVID-19 situation. In some places, utility of that commodity. You will suffer for consuming that commodity. Because goods are coming, but you are not up to reach that commodity. Because time has, the government has kept the time schedule for consuming because of certain unavoidable situations. So you have to go and buy that commodity in that time only. When it is a normal situation, you can go, you can buy the any commodity at any time, any place, anywhere, at whatever the price. So, some difference, because of some problems, suppose some goods are not able to be transported from one place to another place, then suddenly people will suffer shortage of those goods because of lack of transport facility. Goods cannot be delivered from producer point to consumer point. So consumers are need of that commodity, but due to the transport problem, the goods are not able to move. Then what happens? Demand for that commodity will increase. Girls, you will come to know what is mean by demand in your economics first year. I am using the word called as a demand. That is an economical word. Demand means it is the desire for having one commodity. Suppose I am having 10 rupees in my pocket. I want immediately to purchase one biscuit packet. My mind is telling I should go and buy, but I am not interested to pay 10 rupees to buy that commodity. That is not called as demand. When a person is willing to buy a commodity and back it up by paying the price for that, we will call it as demand. So when the goods are not reaching in your place in a required time period, then automatically it will increase the demand. That means people will have more and more interest created in themselves for buying that commodity. Then we call that as a demand. So when the goods are smoothly, without any interruptedly flowing from one place to another place, then it will maintain a sustainable demand. There will not be high demand or low demand, or prices cannot be increased or decreased due to the demand factor. Goods will be in reach of people to satisfy their human wants. The next one will go for third important. Right goods will be delivered to the right person at the right place at the right price. Okay, so right goods. Right goods means what? Those goods which are needed for a person. If you see, the concept is very broader in sense. Example you take, we will go to cool drinks. It is one type of a commodity, liquid commodity. Suppose cool drinks are consumed more in summer. Cool drinks are consumed more in summer. Naturally, demand will be more in summer. And this commodity will be consumed more by those people who are not having any type of allergy problems. They will be showing more interest in consuming cool drinks in the summer. So, right goods. If the same goods are sold in, delivered to the right person, who is the person who is interested in consuming cool drinks? If you don't deliver cool drink to him at a right place, in the right time, the demand for that commodity will diminish, or the people will not show any type of interest in consuming the commodity. Goods can be categorized according to the gender, male, female, according to the age, below 1 year, above 1 year to 5 years, 5 year to 15 years, then we have 15 years to 50 years or old age. Again, in that also we have goods which are specifically intended for special people, male or female, or certain according to the need, according to the requirement, according to the usage, according to the use of that commodity, or according to the need of that commodity, the goods should be delivered. Goods should not move to wrong person at the sold by the seller. Goods should reach to the correct person without any interruption. If you sell those goods, suppose you are a cricketer, you went to a sports shop and you ordered one set of cricket instruments, bat, ball, wickets, bats, gloves, everything, and you gave your address. You gave your address and you made the payment. And you came back to your home. When the businessman sent these goods, by mistake, the boy who brought the goods home deliver, he has delivered those goods to your neighbor. He is a football player. You now tell me, what is the use of cricket instruments to the football player? That means the goods are wrongly delivered to a wrong person. That is, right goods will be delivered to the right person. Actually, the goods should be delivered by the delivery boy to you. By mistake, the delivery boy has delivered the goods to your neighbor, who is not a cricketer, he is a football player. Then what he will use of those goods? What he will do with those goods? He will be no use. The goods will not give any kind of use for him. It is just like a scrap for him. So he will not make a payment. The goods have not reached at the right place. It has reached to the wrong place. So it is one of the difficulty or disadvantage if you do like that. That means who has ordered the goods and where the goods has to go, how those goods has to go, why those goods has to go there only, and how we will get the price from that person is removed from the difficulties when you use commerce. What is our commerce now? It is the sum total of all the activities which are useful in free and uninterrupted flow of goods from the place of production to the place of consumption. We will call that as a commerce. Now the last importance, it removes the difficulties of place. Now in the above example, we have taken apple. It removes the difficulties of place. Suppose if I want to eat one apple, can I go to almost to Jammu Kashmir for one having an apple to satisfy my desire of having apple? Can I travel almost 2000 or some kilometers from almost Hyderabad to Jammu Kashmir for the want of an apple? It's not possible. So my want, how I can satisfy? My want is satisfied with the process of moving the goods. That is, difficulties of place is removed. Goods are produced at one place, but they are delivered at another place and they are used by some other person. Suppose we are getting now, this is a rainy season. In rainy season, we will use more number of umbrellas, we will use more number of raincoats. Now imagine where these umbrellas and raincoats are manufactured. It is manufactured at some place in some state of India, in a remote place. From there, it is being brought to your state, in your area, and they are sold. Suppose you are celebrating Deepavali. Deepavali is a festival of lights. At that time, we light the crackers. Crackers are manufactured in some places of India. So you don't go directly to that place for buying the crackers. Crackers are not produced. They are not manufactured throughout the year, 365 days. Because it is a seasonal, we will use only once. So where they are produced, how they are produced, when they are produced, and how they are brought to other place, they are being using the services of commerce. So commerce is nothing but it includes all those types of activities which you are involving in free uninterrupted flow of goods from the producer point to consumer point. Okay, so place, hindrance of place is removed. Next one, we go to person. So we have seen here hindrance of person, how the goods difficulties of person is removed. Suppose difficulties of person, it removes the difficulties of place, person, then time, what type of goods are produced, when they are produced, when they are supposed to consume, how they are supposed to be consumed, then finance. Without finance, you cannot do any type of business. Suppose if you want to move from one place to another place also, compulsorily you should have money in your pocket. Suppose if you want to go from Hyderabad to Bombay, either you have to go by train, either you have to go by flight, or either you have to go by bus. That means when you enter into this kind of transport, they will take you when you pay the price for them in the form of ticket. If you don't pay the price for ticket, then what is? They will simply tell you, just let out of the bus or train. You will not be allowed to enter into the transport. So finance plays a very important role in our business. So finance is the blood of our business. Without a circulation of the blood in the body, your body doesn't function a minute also. So without a finance, without arranging or allocating proper finance to the business, your business cannot stand still in the competitive world. Then knowledge. When you learn about commerce, you should have the knowledge of things, what is happening. That is basic knowledge. How you are going, developing in your subject. You should try to gather some important knowledge which is useful to yourself as well. You can learn some things related to your subject also. So suppose now you have to do some business. What type of business you want to do? How the business should be done? Why we have to do that business? What is the fate of that business in future? How we have to do that business? Whether what is the nature of that business? Whether it is a manufacturing business, whether it is a production business, whether it is a trading business, or from where we will bring the finance to the business, how we will do marketing for the business, what is the trend of the business, everything, the knowledge is needed for us. Without any knowledge means without a proper planning, without knowing anything properly, don't step. Suppose if you want an apple, so first of all you should know where the apples are available in our city, where the godowns are there, who is the seller of the apples, how he is selling. Then you can go and buy. Suppose if you want an apple, but if you go to a vegetable market, you don't find apples there, then you are going at a wrong place and you are asking to the wrong person. So like that, when you do some work, you should have a proper knowledge regarding that. The last one, risk. In every business, we have a risk. In our normal life also, risk is an integral We don't know, we can't say anything. What happens, when it happens, how it happens, to whom it happens. Now see, from past to previous, we are suffering with this psychological effect. Continuous rainfall. Continuously from past 6 months, we are suffering with the virus of COVID-19. So many people, morning we are seeing, but in the evening we are hearing the news, someone has been affected with virus. Someone has died. So risk, uncertainty in the life is common. It will be coming, it will be suffered by any person at any time, anywhere in the normal life as well as in the business. In the normal life, it will be very less. But in the business, it will be very high. So this is the completion of our commerce topic. In the next class, we will be shutting down this topic by continuing our last topic called as a trade. So before I close my one unit, we are left out with a small topic called as a trade and aids to trade. Trade and aids to trade is the last topic left out in our first unit, girls. So after completing that, from this unit, I will be giving you 2 to 3 questions, documents, the video, which you need to copy in your notes. The question answer of that topic I am going to give you as a document in your video. You need to copy that in your notes and prepare for your exam. So any conclusions or any type of comment regarding the class, you can comment me on this video. Thank you very much.